Hello students, welcome back to maths class. So yesterday we finished one 7 marks method, that is substitution method, right? So today we will deal with the logarithmic method. So when we use substitution method, if the given problem is in complex form, right? So then to make that problem into simple form, we will use that substitution method. So when we have to use the logarithmic method, that means taking log on both sides, means see, this problem belongs to logarithmic method. That means by using log we will simplify this and we will solve the problem. So when we have to go for this method, means always remember variable is in terms of x. See, suppose x to the power of, right, value is in terms of x and its power is also in terms of x, right? Value is in terms of x, again its power is in terms of x, or like this, cos x to the power of sin x, power also in terms of x. Then in such cases we will go for log, taking log on both sides, logarithmic method. Okay, remember generally we will have some variable, power will be in terms of numbers, right? But suppose power is also in terms of x values, then we will go for logarithmic method. So now take this one, this question, 7 marks question, very important. By using logarithmic method we will solve this problem. So come on, what is the given problem to you? So given that, what is given value? Y is equal to x to the power of tan x, right, plus sin x to the power of cos x. So both, if you observe, y is given as very complex form, the problem is, isn't it? So y is given as sum of two terms, but each term is value, again it's a variable, and again its power is also in terms of x. Same thing, variable, again its power is in terms of variable, right? In such cases we have to go for logarithmic method. How we have to go for? We will consider y is equal to u plus v. That means we will consider u is equal to first one. What is that? U is equal to x to the power of tan x, right? And v is equal to, we will consider this as sin x to the power of cos x. Okay, so now your y is u plus v. So if we want to find dy by dx, question is find dy by dx, find the derivative of y, means find dy by dx. So it is d by dx of u plus v, right? So is equal to, it is du by dx plus dv by dx. Okay, so this is your first one. So now separately we will find du by dx, and separately we will find dv by dx, then we will substitute in that equation. Little bit lengthy, but if you start solving it will come smoothly, but if you listen one time carefully then it will come smoothly. That means we need du by dx and we need dv by dx. First try to get your du by dx. So take your u. What is u? This is, you consider this as a step 1, right? In step 1 we will find du by dx, in step 2 we will find dv by dx, then we will add both the values. So u is equal to, what is the value? X to the power of tan x, right? This is your u. So I said in the given function value is in terms of x, its power is also in terms of x, then go for logarithmic method. That means taking log on both sides, log u is equal to log of x to the power of tan x. Observe carefully what we are doing. So there is one formula in logarithm. Log a to the power of m is equal to m log a, right? Log a to the power of m is m log a. So log x to the power of tan x can be taken as, come on, what is it? Tan x into log x. Okay, so by applying this formula, which formula? Log a to the power of m is equal to m into log a. If I say which formula, say it along with me, right? So that we will get used to the formulas. So now differentiating with respect to x on both sides. Both sides you differentiate with respect to x. What happens? D by dx of log u is equal to d by dx of, come on, what we got the value we are applying, right? D by dx for both sides, that is tan x into log x. Okay, so you know the formula. What is the formula? D by dx of log of any variable is equal to 1 by of that variable into d by dx of that variable. So instead of x we are having u here, so it is 1 by u into du by dx is equal to, now this one u into v form, product form, derivative of product form. So we can take this as tan x into d by dx of log x, right, plus log x into d by dx of tan x. Okay, so is equal to, it is tan x into d by dx of log x is 1 by x, plus log x into d by dx of tan x is secant square x. Okay, so we want du by dx. To get our dy by dx, what is our dy by dx? Du by dx plus dv by dx. So we are trying to get our du by dx. We want only du by dx, so we send u that side. So come on, this is du by dx is equal to u into, come on, what is the value? Tan x by x plus log x into secant square x. Okay, and what is u? U is equal to, we have taken x to the power of tan x, we considered, isn't it? U is equal to x to the power of tan x. So this is your du by dx. Okay, so now similarly find out dv by dx. Okay, so I said dy by dx, how we will get? By getting du by dx and dv by dx. So they are lengthy values, so not at a time, step wise we will find. First step we will find du by dx. Now step 2 we will find dv by dx. So come on, take your v now. So what is v? V is equal to, it is sin x whole to the power of cos x. What is it? Variable. Again power is variable, right? It is not number. Then we have to take log on both sides. So come on, log v is equal to, we can write log of sin x whole to the power of cos x, right? So again same formula. Which formula we are using? Log a to the power of m is equal to m log a. This formula we have to use. Okay, so we can write this is equal to, come on, cos x into log of sin x. Clear? Now differentiating with respect to x on both sides. With respect to x on both sides we have to do. So come on, d by dx of log v is equal to d by dx of cos x into log of sin x. Okay, so d by dx of log of any value is equal to 1 by of that variable into d by dx of that variable. This is u into v form product, right? D by dx of u into v form. So it is cos x into d by dx of log of sin x, right? Plus log of sin x into d by dx of cos x. Okay, so which formula? U into v formula. D by dx of u into v, u dv by dx plus v du by dx. So is equal to, it is cos x d by dx of log of sin x. Log of any variable is that variable into d by dx of that variable. D by dx of sin x is cos x plus log of sin x into d by dx of cos x is minus sin x. Okay, so cos x into cos x, cos square x. Okay, cos square x by sin x, plus of minus minus. So we can write this as sin x into log of sin x. Okay, so this is your 1 by v, right, into dv by dx. We want dv by dx, we don't want this v, send the other side. So dv by dx is equal to v into, what is the value? It is cos square x by sin x minus sin x into log of sin x. Okay, so now substitute your v value. What is v? V is equal to sin x, right, to the power of cos x into, what is that? Cos square x by sin x minus sin x into log of sin x. Okay, so this is your dv by dx. So we got all the values. We need du by dx, we need dv by dx. Therefore dy by dx is equal to dv du by dx plus dv by dx. Du by dx, x to the power of tan x, right, into tan x by x plus log x into secant square x. Okay, plus sin x whole to the power of cos x into cos square x by sin x minus sin x into log of sin x. Okay, so that is the answer of this question. So very simple. You can say, madam, very lengthy. Yes, lengthy, but it is simple if you understand the concept. Very simple. Whenever variable is having again power as a variable, not number, then we have to take a log. But here two terms are there, that's why we will consider first term as u and second term as v. Suppose only y is equal to x to the power of tan x, for that only we will take log on both sides. But for y, we are having two terms, that's why you consider this as, this term is also variable, power is variable, and for this term also variable and power is variable, right? For that sake, we have to take u is equal to this and v is equal to this. So we have to find dy by dx, that is d by dx of u plus v, right? So d by dx of u plus d by dx of v, that is what we have to get. So separately try to get your du by dx, then separately try to get your dv by dx, then you write those two values together, that will be your answer. So whenever it is like that, problem is given like this, right? Some variable, again power is variable, take log on both sides. Taking log on both sides, log u is equal to log of x to the power of tan x. That's why we are taking a log y. Log a to the power of m can be written as m log a. So log of x to the power of tan x can be written as tan x into log x. We can easily differentiate this term. We cannot differentiate this directly, right? We don't have any formula for x to the power of tan x in differentiation. But after applying the log, what happens? It will be tan x into log x. This is u into v form. We can apply the differentiation for this. We cannot apply differentiation directly. That's why, suppose variable is having power as a variable, we have to take a log on both sides. Then log of a to the power of m is equal to m log a. Values will come into product form, not in power form, so that whenever it is product form, differentiation u into v, we will apply u into dv by dx plus v into du by dx form, we will apply that formula. Okay, same thing there also, v is equal to sin x, again power is cos x. We don't have any direct formula for that, so you take log for that. Log a to the power of m, formula is m into log a, right? So we can write m into log a can be written as cos x into log of sin x. Now it is in the product form, u into v, we can easily take the differentiation. That's why whenever variable, power is also variable, we have to take a log. So log a to the power of m is equal to m into log a. It will comes into product form. Once it is product form, u into v, we can differentiate the formula easily, problem easily. Once you got du by dx, in step 1 we got du by dx, and in step 2 we got dv by dx. Once we got du by dx, dv by dx, you take your dy by dx. That will be the your answer. Okay, so practice this problem. If anything is not getting, once again you watch it. Actually this is big advantage, right? Generally we will take the class and we will leave, but here you are having lot of advantage from this class, isn't it? So utilize it properly, right? So that's all for today. Have a nice day.